Andrew, you are not the father.
Yes, indeed. Maury Povich has made a career out of those results. DNA testing on his show, is the child yours? Are you really related? Now there are home DNA tests that claim to be able to do the same thing, but do they work? Dr. Joel Eissenberg is a professor of biochemistry and molecular biology at St. Louis University, here to talk about the over-the-counter versions. Good morning to you. Morning. Doc, we've all become very used to kind of self-diagnosing. We've got the thermometers and the blood pressures and the blood sugar machines that we do for diabetes and things. This seems to have just been the next step, right?
I guess so. You know, the speed with which the cost of DNA sequencing has declined has been astonishing, and that combined with the dramatic improvements in computer speeds and computer memory, makes it possible to put within reach to the average American their own DNA sequence.
So these tests over the counter, maybe $100, saliva test, do they work? Are they worth it? Can they give you a false positive?
Well, they can give you information that you may not know what to do with, and it would be helpful to share that information with your physician if you want to act on that information.
And you told me off air, prior to going on the air, you said that a small percentage of them end up with the results that really surprise people, like, oh my goodness, that's not really my dad, kind of thing.
Oh, right. As regards paternity testing, somewhere between 2% and 5%, depending on the population, people can discover that their custodial father is not their biological
father. Do you like this idea, folks just buying them at the drugstore and doing it themselves?
Well, you know, I think it's liberating. It's you know, it's freedom of choice, and so in that sense, we can't interfere with it. But I suggest to people that they talk to their physician before they get tested to prepare themselves for the unexpected.
And it's not just paternity. Can you look at things like diabetes and blood pressure, heart issues, any particular diseases or disorders? Does that help too?
Well, you can. For instance, many of your viewers may be familiar with Angelina Jolie, the actress who discovered that she had a mutation in the BRCA1 gene, which made her 60 to 90% likely to have breast cancer. And so she elected to have a bilateral mastectomy to reduce her risk. Those are the more dramatic and clear-cut cases. But for diseases like diabetes, heart disease, stroke, there may be associations with certain sequence, but they don't have much predictive value at this point. So it would be a good idea to talk to your physician if your DNA analysis comes up with that risk. Of course, for people in those cases, the advice to stop smoking, to maintain a healthy weight, and to exercise will also mitigate your risk, and you don't need DNA testing.
There you save your money, basically, is what he's saying. Thank you, doctor. We appreciate your time this morning. That is Dr. Joel Eissenberg from St. Louis University. If you'd like more information on more of his thoughts, we've got a link to it on our website as well as our Fox 2 mobile app. We'll be right back.